Hello.
It's our moment to be massive, and I think it's Christmas time. Molly's doing a ram. Yes, she is, because she is cool. Mark is here, and so is Ryan, although he wishes his name was Brian. Oh. Where the girl? They are so late because we cannot wait. Yeah. Yes, come on, Mollie King. Yes, yes, yes. Oh my God, umpire! I had like a. Okay, well it went out of bounds. I've won the match.
I'm Rochelle. She's Mollie. Together we make Rochelle.
Pump the tunes out, Marky. We're number one. Everybody, we're number one.
Who are you talking to, girls?
Even when Molly's not trying to be funny.
I'm dancing like a grandmother. I'm literally a 23-year-old hiding in a 10-year-old's body.
Other way around.
Quite upbeat.
I'm the bride that never got to the altar.
I'm all up for a hot night, but I don't want to be burning.
No bubbles, and look like you're squinting, so...
Yeah, no.
All right, I think we get the...
He's gone for the cone look today. He's not sure that white is really his colour, and I think he's a little bit embarrassed in front of all his friends. He's like, Mum, why...
But, oh my God! I was doing my
flash!
She went,
I
went, oh!
I said, oh, my flash!
We're going to go to the studio later, so if you need
to sleep. Oh, what a loser! Oh my God, that's so bad!
Go to the photocopier and photocopy me 10 copies of the Saturday's latest album cover.
Hey, my name's Brittany Spears. I'm from Kentland, Louisiana.
Next week's episode, same time, same place. This is my presenting voice. So everything was smooth sailing. Excuse the pun.
Cook some more pancakes because we just can't get enough. See that?
Have you cut the poo out of her bum yet?
No, because it really hurts.
You
and
dirty,
it's really...
dirty girl.
Does anybody else want me to cut some poo out of their bum?
Frankie.
Yeah, I think it's definitely my calling. Enough of the dance moves and the singing. Sticking to the drums next time. At least I can have a good sit down. I don't have to worry about putting on the tight dresses. So, forget the sats. I'm going to be the drummer.
On her way in, Mollie decides to really wind Mark up.
Oh, I just need to quickly... I just have to quickly get the card and I'll be back.
No, she's not.
I'm here with Nikki. It's just I ran really late. We were joking.
Oh, okay.
Would I be?
Yes.
No?
If you came up to me with that fist, I would laugh.
Listen, I'm
and I'm the chocolate. Together we make a cake.
I used to make things like this for Brittany. She never wrote back.
I said, James, he said, because I threw your cake away, I'll save you a muffin. Now, I went just to have my photos taken for the single cover, and guess what? The muffin's gone. So now I'm on the hunt. I'm going to show you around the set, of course. But really, what my main aim is to find this muffin back. Because if you see the muffin, you tell me.
You know, I wanted... to know I'm eating a pancake.
Right, we can order up again.
Flip. Not flip yet. Oh God. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Yeah!
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh,
oh my
there's a disease in the camp.
Benuna, 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 it's your day.
I got it. One of them.
One of them.
And now we're actually here on a set.
Now we're actually here.
Now we're actually here. Oh my god.
Would you like a ticket, ma'am? Would you like some soda with that?
There we go. It's all working.
Out my way.
Out my way.
Samantha.
Where's my money?
The difference between love and marriage is that marriage is a commitment, whereas love can be spontaneous.
Give me a Jimmy Choo's. Wait,
this is a good one. There was a lady, right? Who, shush! Nick will like this one, right?
I've heard this too much.
Well, you haven't.
Is it when they do
is
that?
Is this about the snake? Could we have a story, please, Molly? Okay,
this
right.
This is the snake story.
Don't say it! So there was a lady who had a pet snake. And she loved the snake like it was her baby. One day, the snake just lost its appetite. And she was like, oh my god, my poor baby. He's just not hungry. So she left it for a day. Then it got to the second day, and he still wasn't eating anything. So she thought, right, this is so weird. So she took it to the vet. And the vet was like, okay, don't worry. Just try and get his favourite snacks and, you know, put it into small bits and just...
coax him and treat him.
Anyway, one night, she was lying in bed, just asleep, and she woke up, and next to her was the snake. Now, I don't mean he was wrapped up in a ball. He was lying parallel next to her, rigor mortis. Completely rigor mortis.
Where is this? Right.
Completely rigor mortis. And she was like, ah, I got my snake filled up. The vet. She filled up the snake.
When she saw the snake.
So she moved out of the vet, and he said, oh my goodness, whatever you do, just get out of the house and just shut the door, just shut the window, just get out of that house right now. I had to catch my breath there. And what actually had happened was when snakes are going to eat their prey, they actually starve themselves and then they line themselves up against the prey to measure themselves, to check they could fit it in their body. So he was going to eat her.
Oh, but he was
that is why he was lying next to her, because he was going to eat her.
But he wasn't, it was my friend's sister's boss.
Although a lot of people I've told have also heard the story.